Welcome to our virtual Thanksgiving celebration. While it is a great shame that we can't meet together face to face, it is good that we can still enjoy watching some of the things that our students have been up to this year and to celebrate the end of the year together in this way. As I watched the different performances, I was amazed by the many gifts that God has given each of these children, each one unique and different, made in the image of God and precious in His sight. I hope that you can break out the gingerbread, popcorn, fruit tarts, and enjoy watching the Thanksgiving celebration together. To start the evening, let's reflect on the year with a montage of images, and then I'll hand you over to our junior school MCs.
Something is about blind man got the cripple on his feet. He's the one the wind and waves obeyed. He cast out evil spirits and he brought the dead alive. And he fed 5,000 people in one day. So let the children sing, we'll go glory to Jesus. Lift your voice to him, go glory to Jesus. See the Holy Savior, he's the Lord of everything. So sing glory to Jesus the King. Jesus, friend of sinners, the lost and the unclean. He said, let the children come to me. He lived a life of fearless love and died upon the cross. Rose again with power to set men free. So let the children sing, we'll go glory to Jesus. Lift your voice to him, go glory to Jesus. See the Holy Savior, he's the Lord of everything. So sing glory to Jesus the King. One day he will come to judge in majesty and power. And every trembling soul will see his face. And all of earth and heaven will cry, worthy is the Lamb. So lift his name in everlasting praise. Let the children sing, we'll go glory to Jesus. Lift your voice to him, go glory to Jesus. Let the whole world sing, we'll go glory to Jesus. Lift your voice and sing, we'll go glory to Jesus. See the Holy Savior, he's the Lord of everything. So sing glory to Jesus the King. Jesus the King, glory to Jesus my King. Yeah.
In junior school, we love to sing, but this year we had to get creative.
We hope you enjoy these musical items from junior school.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning.
The true light who gives light to everyone was coming into the world.
The world is searching for an answer.
Save us. My bones, it goes electric, wavy when I turn it on. Off from my city, off from my home, we're flying up, no ceiling when we in our zone. I got that sunshine in my pocket, got that good soul in my feet. I feel that hot blood in my body when it drops. Ooh, I can't take my eyes off of it, moving so phenomenally. Come on, like the way we rock it. So don't stop. And under the lights, when everything goes, nowhere to hide when I'm getting you close. When we move, well, you already know. So just imagine. Nothing I can see but you when you dance, dance, dance. Feel a good, good creeping up on you. So just dance, dance, dance. Come on. All those things I shouldn't do.
You when you dance, dance. Hi, I'm Sally.
And I'm Maddie. Well, here we are at the end of another school year.
Despite COVID, years 5 to 8 have still had lots of opportunities to come to school, learn new things, play some sport, and be a part of a community that loves Jesus.
Please enjoy these special Thanksgiving presentations from middle school. Be warned, if you have a weak stomach, be prepared to be grossed out by the Year 8 science piece.
In January, we sat below the sweltering red-hot sun. We knew that time was nearing to the ending of our fun.
February was Year 6 camp via double-decker bus. Go-karts, beach and treetops, we all made such a fuss.
In March, there came the odour, a bit like smelly poo, of dead mice hidden in the walls, the roofs and even shoes.
I feel like there's something in my shoe. Hey, it's a mouse! Look!
In April, the season science block became the latest big attraction. Watching its removal was an irresistible distraction.
May found us hiking through the mighty Gara Gorge. We walked all day and talked all day. New friendships it did forge.
We have walked! All day!
We have talked all day!
I feel like friendships have been forged.
In June, we were out to run and jump and leap and sweat and throw athletics, cross country and sporting games, even though some didn't want to go.
No, I'm not going.
In July, we had new fun with the start of comps galore, from handball, laser tag and soccer, and then so many more.
In August, lockdown brought new platforms, so new and hard to use.
Stupid Chromebook.
Online learning was very difficult. Perhaps COVID was a ruse.
For 1 week in September, we all became gold seekers. Some struck it rich, some lost it all, but lots of happy eurekas.
Eureka!
Eureka!
In October, normality returned again. We got to settle back. To life before the corona bug, we'd missed our friends as Jack.
The building of the new science block was impossible to ignore, with endless beeps, painful scrapes, and a screeching concrete saw.
In December, the year was at an end. Another year was through. Full of mice and sport and screams and fuss.
We're here at Year 7 Failure Day, where we've set up a lot of activities for the kids to fail out, fail at actually, and fail speaking. That's my job today. Why are we doing this?
To learn that it's not about the end result.
Yeah, that's not about the end result, it's all about giving 100%, isn't it? Yep, why else? What are some other reasons why we would be doing it?
To fail.
To fail, yeah. So learn that actually it's good to fail.
Yeah, it's good to fail.
It's good to fail, okay. Any other reasons?
Crack out the teachers.
To crack out the teachers, yeah, provide entertainment for us is a good reason.
It's just to show that everyone's not perfect.
Here we've got the girls on the unicycle, trying to get right on the unicycle. How'd we go, Xanthi?
All right.
I don't think you went all right. I think you failed. And why is that?
Because I haven't practiced before and I haven't really done it before.
Yeah, which is good. And what are you learning about failing?
That it's okay to fail.
Yeah, it's good.
It's good to like learn to fail, because otherwise if you just succeed in life, you're not like, you might succeed once, but you need to fail just so you can succeed better. Teaches everyone, or the kids that are doing it, to realise that it's okay to fail, and that the more you fail, the more you'll succeed.
Because in life you won't always succeed, you'll sometimes fail.
Like, it's not about failing, but like, yeah, just about trying your best and having a go.
This term in science, Year 8 has been learning all about the organ system in plants and humans. So far this term we have dissected a flower, a kidney, chicken wing and sheep's heart and lungs. It has been an amazing way to see God's creativity in an elegant complexity that he's built into the living world.
We'd like to show you this model digestive system, made using real food and digestive enzymes. It was a helpful model to show mechanical and chemical stages of digestion. Enjoy.
2021 has been another unusual year for people all around the world, yet Senior School at Carinya has continued to be a great place filled with learning, laughing and enjoying the amazing world that Jesus has made. We've drawn and painted, designed and built, written and spoken, kicked and climbed, and experimented and performed. Everything that we have done has been an opportunity to use the gifts and skills that God has given us to serve Him and others.
Whilst we've had to adjust our expectations and missed opportunities like excursions, sport and performances, we have joyfully embraced new technologies and processes to make learning and relationships happen. The HSC, while delayed, has occurred despite COVID and floods, and we have built stronger connections with our classmates, teachers and families. Here's a short snapshot of Senior School in 2021. Thanks to everyone for making it happen.
ਸ਼ਿਆਕਾਲ ਤੇ ਸਵਾਗਤ ਹੈ ਤੁਹਾਡਾ
ਹੈਲੋ ਦਨ ਸਲਾਮਤ ਦਾਤਾਂ
ਵਾਲਾ ਗੇ ਤਾਤੇ ਲੋ ਮੁਲਾ
ਨੀ ਹਾਉ ਹਾਈ ਨੀ
ਨੀ ਹਾਉ ਮੈਂ
ਬੁਲਾ ਨੀ ਨਤਾਕਾ ਵਨਾਕਾ ਮਾਈ
ਯਾਮਾ ਕੁਬਿਆਈ
ਗੁੱਡ ਡੇ ਐਂਡ ਵੈਲਕਮ
ਵਾਲਾ ਗੇ ਤਾਤੇ ਲੋ ਮੁਦੋ ਮਾਲਾ HSIE.LOT.TATULONELULA ਕਰਿੰਗਾ Ένα βακαρατάκι βουλί ο κοτ και μου νίνα βακαρατάκα τίκο κοινά βέει ταμπανί βουλί και να λέσω μη και μαμί βουλί τα τίκο έκαρνια.
Σιόνκο, χουν λέει καλή, χιέν τα λύσου, νιπονγουά, τίλι, κου τα λύσου, τσικι τόν βινεν τσινέ, χω χωακό, σιόνέ, κοιμιού τί σιακάι.
Dari peradaban manusia ke penjelajahan suatu tempat atau dari luatan ke daratan alam yang terbentang luas.
Karobar kive chalta hai te vatavaran kive kaam karta hai.
我们在HSC中涵盖了所有内容。
Mami, vuli o konaka ke mami vaka bauta.
Hanya engkau adalah Tuhan, engkau telah menjadikan langit, yang langit segala dengan segala bala tenteranya, dan bumi dengan segala yang ada di atasnya, dan laut dengan segala yang ada di dalamnya.
Nehemiah 9:6.
在此不分希腊人和犹太人。 受割礼的和未受割礼的, 野蛮人, 司基泰人, 为奴的, 自主的, 唯独基督是一切, 又在一切之中。
Thank you.
My name is Mitchell Clark, and the title of my major work was Memories I Built as a Child, My Grandparents. So it was based on an experience I had last year before when my grandparents moved from their property in Armidale to move to Tamworth to be closer to the family. I did four artworks for the series. So that was the main house, the driveway, a willow in the front yard, and the moon and sign as you enter the property. I probably spent upwards of $1,500 on there. And yeah, I think the final piece count was about 2,000 pieces in total. Yeah, so I took some photos in our last weeks there just to get the head start on the HSC. And with that, I initially put it through a mosaic converter provided by Bricklink as well. And that worked out for a while, but then I realised that didn't really bring enough detail to them. So I sort of tried to improvise with some shading. Initially I did one by one round plates, and they were useful because if you made a mistake, then you could just, they're easier to take off, and they were affordable as well. But then I started to add some depth. So I added tiles, regular plates, foliage for the trees and everything like that. And yeah, it sort of came out from there, and I think it benefited the artwork because of it.
Hi everyone, my name is Chinecherem Precious Agor, and the title of my major work is called Umuwainde Worom Megutem Nemetutokwam, which translates into English as Women That Prepared Me, Built Me and Influenced Me. My artwork is about all the women that have influenced me and helped me accept who I am. My grandmom, I drew her. She has like a big impact in my life because she raised me and she taught me about life and how to deal with it and how to accept things the way they are. And my friends at school, even they actually don't look like them, but I drew them. Because they are really nice people. What I did was practice more on how to draw faces, and they were not actually good faces. They were like, you know, just a portrait. I just drew so many figures. And mainly they were like females, and what joined them together was the colors I used, which helped to explain about all the connections they had together as women and how they have accepted themselves over the years.
Charlie Lowe, artwork title is Two Side Stories. Of artwork is about like conflicts. So I have more specifically for before and after, or as some people like to call it, for effect and cause. The first idea I got from one of my other classes on history is we were looking over for conflict in the Pacific unit. The process is mainly just finding images of war zones like before and after the conflict. Like, and in some of the works in the collage, conflicts between two perspectives, like for Pearl Harbor and Hiroshima and Nagasaki conflicts. Well, one is from the American perspective and the other being Japanese perspective.
Hello, my name is Zoya, and the title of my artwork is Climate-Related Disaster Has Increased 80% Over the Last Four Decades. It's a massive watercolor painting that was inspired by Da Vinci's Last Supper, made a reference to his composition, which has the dining table with 12 people in it. So for my artwork, each dishes they eating is representing a specific climate disaster that's human introduced. For the people who's eating the plate, it's like we are consuming the environments, which will have a massive impact on us afterwards. And I've left the center of the painting out as if like no one is in control. And then on the window, there's a clock, which almost pointing to 12 o'clock, which means we still have time to save our planet and protect our environment for later use. Miss Nona used a projector, which once I finished the initial sketch, like a brief plan, he projected and then I could trace it over the massive watercolor paper I had. And after that, I would just fill in the colors and printing, adding details in, and it probably took a long time to do it. I think for one of the fishes I did, it could took like four hours for like the fish I did. So yeah, I spent a lot of time, but I still rushed it in the end. Luckily, I still was able to finish it. So yeah, it's good.
Hey, I'm Tom. This is my major work. It's a sprinkler that you set up next to your house to protect it from bushfires. I got the idea from my dad because he went and fought bushfires during that really bad bushfire season. He was just telling me about it one day and I was like, imagine if you could defend your house from bushfires without risking your life. Turns out there was already bushfire protection units. You set them up on your roof sort of thing, but they're not easily accessible and they cost a fortune to have. So I thought I'll try and build one cheaper, which is, that's a fair bit cheaper. The average price for a bushfire protection unit is like $1,500. Mine's about $200. And then they're easy to access. It's just, you just twist this and it comes down. I have a fire hose, which is resistant to fires, which is always helpful. And that just plugs into here, plugs into any taps on the side of the house anywhere. And the sprinkler is like a low pressure one, so it works easily with low pressures. So it means you can have a lot of them without it affecting how like high the water pressure is. And you just turn the tap on and it's good to go. And then that is a bushfire sprinkler on top that I bought from Peel Irrigation. So it's made to protect houses from bushfires.
Cool, I'm Isaac Thomason. For my major work, I made a like shelf slash cabinets for my record player and some records. The reason I went and made this, in my room, don't have a lot of space. And for a long time, I had my record player and amplifier like just sitting on my desk and it was very crammed. I'd seen online a lot of people make kind of compact kind of desks or shelving spaces where their records and speakers or everything were all in one sort of unit. And so I decided to do that, which should save a lot of space in my room, less clutter hopefully. So the amplifier and the record player, they just kind of slot in at the moment, and I did that for aesthetic purposes. I think it just looks nice how it sits flush with the surface. You'll see there's a gap at the back where all the wires will go down and out the back of the cabinet.
My name is Matthew, and I made a bed slash seat. The idea was to have to be able to comfortably sleep in the back of my car van thing, so that I can travel around and just camp in the back. And so it folds, this back portion folds up into the backrest of the seat. So I just chuck the cushion back there and then gracefully climb into the back and chuck that up like that. Pull that forward and then you've got a solid seat, which is very nice. Oh, I also put in a storage compartment so that I could chuck stuff under the bed and space wasn't wasted. It's under the big mattress, and so you just chuck that over there. Whoop, it's gonna stay. And then just here, lifts up. Then you can chuck stuff under the bed, which is very nice. Then easily just chuck that back. And voila.
Hi, my name is Zoya, and my D&T major project is titled Creative Coral Dress. I thought it would be easy to make one to start with, so I thought, oh, I'll just make it from scratch. But after asking the textile teacher, I realized you need years of practice to actually use the paper pattern and all that. So I changed my idea to found a secondhand dress online and then thrifted, and according to my theme, which is coral reefs, I added a piece of embroidery with some tulle fabric around it as like the sea waves. Like, if I could change one thing, I would change the color of the fabric, because when I bought the fabric, I didn't actually compare it with my dress. I just started the embroidery process. And after I finished the embroidery process, I realized, oh, they don't actually go that well together. So, but overall, I was still happy with how it turned out. And I'm excited to put it in my portfolio at the end of year 12.
All right, name's Johnny Lai, and I worked on this guitar for my D&T major work. It inspired me to make a electric guitar. It was actually Mick Gordon's and David Levy's works for Doom and Doom Eternal soundtracks. For guitars, you see it now, it's made out of pre-existing parts made from and like just modified from when I got the donor guitar. So most of the modification that you could see is, well, obviously for paint and a violet crumble, and one of the horn edges have been removed. The most challenging part of the process is getting the paint correct, because of it being violet crumble. Well, it used one base coat, three gold coats, three purple coats, and multiple clear coats. Clear coats could vary between 3 to 7. If I just remember correctly, it was 5 coats of clear.
Oh, that's a lot of paint.
Yeah, it is like 90% of this is just paint.
Hi, my name's Tom. For my major works, I decided to make a rugged portable Bluetooth speaker in the form of an ammunition box to make it sort of rugged and durable, something that can be thrown around a bit and it doesn't break. So the inspiration for this come from my current workplace. I work in a tool shop, and we actually make specific work site radios. And I wanted to try and create a more personalized custom version of one of those to use at home in the workshop when I'm working on my car, because using my phone isn't good enough, it's not loud enough. So that's why I decided to make this speaker. Probably the most challenging part of building the speaker was sourcing some of the components. Some of the components weren't too easy to find, so I had to order some of them from online. And then some some parts of it were recycled as well. So where I could recycle parts, I would try and recycle bits for it as well, just to also try and keep costs low. In the end, it ended up costing me just under $300 to make. So I'm pretty happy with how that came out, because that's around the price where you can buy store-bought ones from. It's got two speakers. Both of the speakers are rated at 250 watts each, so 500 in total. So it is very loud. And it's got a good bass. It does actually sound surprisingly well. When the box is sealed up, it has got a rubber seal around in the top of the lid, so when the box is sealed, it actually has some really good acoustics, and it surprised me just how well it actually sounds. So I'm very happy with how it sounds.
I trust that you were able to enjoy all of the performances and presentations. As always, plenty of variety, and so wonderful to see the kids having such a great time performing. As we finish, let me read to you from Luke chapter 2, where Mary says, "My soul glorifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Saviour, for he has been mindful of the humble state of his servant." What a wonderful fact that Jesus, being mindful of us, came down to this earth to save those who love him. I hope that this Christmas you can reflect on the truth of Jesus, and that at this time, God became man. We thank you for trusting us with the education of your children this year.
We have enjoyed watching your children learn and grow in their knowledge of God's amazing world.
We delight in the community that we share, knowing that through Christ, we are made to live and learn together.
It's been a pleasure to work in partnership with you, home and school together, as we have watched another group of Year 12 students go out into the world.
Over the holiday break, we hope you have a safe and enjoyable time with your family and friends in God's amazing world.
From all the staff at Carinya, thank you for your support during the year, and we look forward to seeing you back again next year.
Merry Christmas!
Nearly got me.
Where's Dave?
You know Dave, he's got this obsession with the principal. Something about didn't like his fancy schmancy suit. He was going to take him down. Anyway, we don't need him.
Fair enough. Yeah.
Guys, so we've worked out it wasn't Chalk Boy.
It wasn't Greek Chalk Boy.
We need some tools to help.
Yeah.
We need Go-Go Gadget Man.
Oh, not these guys again.
Go-Go Gadget Man, are you alone?
Pretty sure I am.
Great. Yeah. Look, mate, we've got a really tough one. We need to find out who the big boss is. Any gadgets you might have to help us?
Well, I do have this little bad boy that we've just designed. This will actually send you back in time.
No way.
That is exactly what we need.
Yeah.
Forward as well?
If you choose to.
Yeah.
Good.
Only problem with time travel, I've already got a few grey hairs. It won't add any of them, will it?
Definitely won't. It will improve them.
I mean, will it improve my moustache? Nothing will improve your moustache.
Right, let's get this. Let's get this bread.
Out of here. Do we click out or not, mate?
Oh, see you later.
Go-Go Gadget Man gave us this device to go back in time to try to catch the villain. Let's see if it works. Fellas. What's the date? 200 BC?
200 million BC!
Yeah. Okay, let's get out of here.
It's Maximus! Quick, to the defensive turtle!
Push the button, Dave!
Okay. William Wallace.
Man, I don't like this guy.
I can't hear him. Can he speak up?
He's saying something about freedom.
You'll never take our freedom!
We're pretty close to the right time.
Yeah.
Okay. You too. This is Trigger.
Hello.
What time is it, kids?
2 o'clock.
2 o'clock. 2 o'clock. Okay. Yeah.
8 o'clock.
8 o'clock.
David's o'clock.
Oh no, that's trouble. Enough of this shenanigans. We need a real answer. Mrs. Trickett, what year?
Year two, you all know. It's the year 2019.
Perfect. Tell us, Mrs. Trickett, what has been happening? There's something funny going on.
I really don't know what's going on, but we've got these weird messages coming from the office. I don't know what to make of it.
Has anyone signed in late today?
Did anything funny happen when you signed in late?
There was chalk everywhere. I heard a really weird laughter.
Come on, we gotta find the villain. Let's go.
Yes.
Oh. Hey guys. 20 times, sir. What does it say? Oh, 2019. Hang on. 20. One of your special powers. Smelling chalk. Get on the scent, big guy. Get on the scent.
Let's go.
This is the good stuff. You got it, my accomplice? Oh yes, this little piece of really good.
Hello, Corinne, Christian School, Robin speaking. Can I help you?
Quick, 2021, we need to get back. Oh, what time is it?
Oh, 2021.
Yes. Right, so it all makes sense.
Yeah.
We've got Rob in reception. Rob must have Dave.
That's the only explanation. She's got something against him.
Sense.
We need to find her and find Dave.
That's where he is. Right. Let's go.
We've got you now. Give us back our beloved Mr. Jones.
No. Come on, Chalkies, where are you?
Oh, no way. Still water, fine.
See ya. No. Hold on, I know. My hero. I'll just get my hero. Hello, are you ready? We're on.
Get him on foot.
No, don't hurt my lovey. Don't hurt my collie, my hero.
Oh. All right then. If it's gonna be this way, you're gonna have to surrender and come to the office with us.
Okay. Just don't do anything more. No more to him.
Let's strike up a deal.
A few moments later.
Principal Dave, we've apprehended her. We know who the boss is. Would you like us to bring her in?
Bring her in.
Bring her in, strong boys.
Go.
All right, let's get into this. Listen here, Rob. This has got to stop. No more chalk.
No more chalk boy. No more Greek boy. This has got to stop, and it's got to stop now.
Now, hold on. There's one condition. Just one condition.
What's that?
No longer principal, thanks.
Oh, gee. So that's not going to go down well.
I can't believe this shenanigans and nonsense. I'm taking my fancy schmancy suit, and I'm done with this job.
Fellas, don't worry. I've got a plan. We'll make him CEO.
That doesn't really solve a problem, though. I haven't seen Investigator Dave since we had the time machine.
2019?
Yeah.
In year two, I think. Yeah. We haven't seen him since. That's a long time. Dave!
Oh, it's so good to see you, mate!
Where have you been?
I've been stuck in 2019. 2 years it's taken me to get here.
Oh. Dave, you'll never guess what happened. She was the bad guy, or woman as it may be, and we got rid of the principal.
Yeah! I never liked him in his fancy schmancy suit.
Yeah!